Hello everyone, it's Jen from Old Tinkerer Studio, and today's Photoshop CC tutorial is going to be how to take a color photo and make it monochromatic. I would recommend making a copy of your photo just in case you need to revert back to the original for whatever reason. You can do that by hitting Ctrl J, and we'll leave the original one labeled as background and keep it locked. So on your new layer, we'll make sure that it is highlighted and go down to the bottom of your panel and click on a new adjustment layer and choose black and white. So your image is now a neutral monochromatic photo. But in order to make the image into a rich monochromatic image, we need to make some adjustments. By using the property sliders on the adjustment layer, you can emphasize or de-emphasize specific portions of the photo. By using the modify slider, you can click on any area of the image and slide across the image to affect the color of the original photo. You see here I'm making the sky light, and then I can make it really dark as well. And you can see the blue slider changing as I'm doing this. Now you can also manually move the sliders, and this will affect the image as well. Like I could use cyan and change the color of the sky. I could use greens and yellows to change the color of the moss on the rocks. Make them lighter or darker. You can also tint the image by checking the box next to tint and clicking on the color box. Make it a little bit darker, a little bit more desaturated. You can also choose a filter using the drop-down menu. Anything that you want to change on here, let's try neutral density. And you can use the sliders just like you can anywhere else. Make it a little bit darker, a little bit lighter, whatever to your own choosing. You can also use a gradient map adjustment layer to further refine the image. This is called photographic toning. You can click on the adjustment layer icon and choose gradient map. Click on the right arrow next to the gradient. Click on the gear icon and choose photographic toning. Click OK to replace the existing options. And then you can experiment with the gradients to choose the one that you like best. You can always click on the actual gradient itself to make any changes that you want. And it's really just that simple. I hope you found this helpful. Have a good day.